have any proof. I should have had them sign for it.
Should have had them sign for it.
Should have signed it out.
Yeah, right.
But they, it said that Fanning run it, or somebody, and I don't remember who owned it, but Fanning run it anyway. So that's why you get Fanning in it anyway.
Fanning, yeah.
So we might as well
Hit
the pretty frosty this month.
Yeah.
But it was real white when the sun burst in the top of it.
You got a little more snow.
Slide it more moisture
out of this guy.
We're trying to
get ahead of
him. Keep on snowmobiling up through the notch. We were up through yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
The trail is good, considering. When we got up towards New Hampshire, there was about seven or eight inches of snow. But we each year, the seven or eight.
Been up Step Falls?
You can just stop.
Yep. You're familiar with it?
Any time, yeah.
Sometime this summer we'll go up there again. Beautiful area.
Or you can just see some eyepiece. It's not recording now, though.
Yeah, it is.
That was the first house in Grafton.
First house in Grafton, right over there. Okay, did you get that, Francis?
Here,
Joe.
Here, give me that.
Watch your window down.
Yeah, I'm gonna go over you.
He's gonna get
glass.
With the other.
I'll get it with the other.
Francis, I understand you took a lot of pictures in Germany last year.
Yeah, he did.
He's in the
bag. That's the pocket for it.
Oh, okay.
All right, we'll try. You got that, right?
Okay, did you get that, Francis? Park headquarters over here?
Yeah, we got it.
And he showed me to put it in.
Yeah.
Over here.
They were supposed to build a tool shed and drive last summer, and they had a place graded up right in there. They had stakes right there. They had that graded off last week. There was no last fall. They were going to build this summer. Something happened. And then there was another house right where that car ran, right off in that car.
Okay, see that cellar hole there,
Francis? Do you get that cellar hole?
Yeah.
Well, with the Morse place, which doesn't show on your map.
The Morse place here.
Yeah.
Real interesting. Black Morse lived, well, his brother lived down to Hanover. He taught for years in school down in Mexico, I think. He was living here back, I don't know, probably in the 40s, early 50s, something. Hadn't paid his light bill, so he was out and paid his light bill and come back and he was on. This is Moss Brook, Moss Brook and Payne Brook separate right there, just a lot of it.
See if you can walk, like walk in there.
Yeah, why don't you?
So at one time there was a mill here?
Yeah, the mill. There was a pin right across there somewhere. There was a pin set in the front of the mill. Must have been right about here from the way the picture shows. They built most of them right over the place like this so they could have the coal mill.
You out in that deep stuff.
Oh, just don't bother me. It's all wedged all the way around. The only way you can get back up is to go down the brook and come up over the bank down below. Back, 10 years ago probably, there was a young moose come out here. Must have been the night the cask had him or something. He jumped over and went down in there and broke his legs and died right down there. You come up in the summer sometime, Marvin, you can go through the needle. Straight ledge on this side, and that side, and the other side. That is what they call a jail's fall. You can go through the back. Nobody coming the other way, it's okay to go.
Yeah.
They're building a house now, getting ready. They must have just put this railing on.
Yeah. So Oh, right in there somewhere was that?
Down.
Center of any sort?
All the kids from down below went to school down at the tide school, which is down right by Batchelor's trailer is, below the house. There's a house there and then the trailer.
Oh, yeah.
The old schoolhouse is right there.
Oh.
And they moved it down. It was the dry cell. The clone of what it was. I don't think you want to go down to Moose Cave.
No.
It's probably about 1/8 of a mile down in there.
Yeah, it's quite a
hike down.
Quite a little hike down.
Nice, yeah, nice place to go in the summertime, but no place
yeah.
to go.
Yeah.
Well,
that's
Table Rock right up there. You can see the rock sticking out. Looks like you can go right underneath it. On the side of the mountain again, cut this all off and it'll be the summer of 33, I guess.
33, might due to the mill on top of there.
Oh my.
The mill was long gone.
Oh, the mill was long gone? Yeah.
No, I can't remember the mill ever being there. We had pictures of it.
That is a long time ago then. Now, how long have you lived up in this area?
No, I was born here.
You were born here?
Yeah.
So you are the authority on this area.
When I went to work for forestry, I worked in Eustace for 3 years, in Machias for 3 years, in Old Town for 20 years, and then moved back here in 73. Yeah, I graduated from Gould in 35.
So, where would we go now?
Right on up the road.
Right on up the road, okay.
We'll keep going, we'll go up until we come to uptown, we get up to, we run out of Grafton, and then we'll turn around and come back.
Okay.
This is a bad place here, getting in and out. We've got two great places. That's one thing the scenic byway was supposed to do, was change the bad place. And I feel trail right there, that's why that old
trail there.
Come in for a kiss. light came and I went to the road. The road was closed up for 3-4 days. You can see right here, see that little hump side of the road there where they went through?
Yeah.
That's what could slip down. They went right across the road the first winter. They just come around it. Big logs and mushy, they could go and mingle with it, and the next summer they built right over.
Yeah, it does that once in a while, doesn't it? Yeah. Just,
that's why the sluice is over.
The sluice in here. So all those logs built up.
Yeah, you got
the thing that was cut up on the side of the mountain, and mine was so steep they could haul it down. They just put it into the, that sluice.
Sort of base in here. This is now the Appalachian Trail entrance here.
That's where you go on the other side.
That's
the scenic byway is supposed to enlarge that parking lot there too.
Okay.
The rest of the one gravel bit, there's all gravel bit out there.
How far along is that process of the scenic byway? Talking stage.
Oh, well, supposedly they were supposed to do some work last summer. They were supposed to have done that gravel bit there last summer, the parking area.
Yeah.
They didn't do it because we got to talk to John Metcalf, who was the park ranger. They said they couldn't get a permit. After we dug into it a while, they never applied for one. That's the reason they couldn't get one.
They didn't get one.
Cemetery, right? I.G. Lane, so the road, the whole new road goes to the left of I.G. Lane's house. Bridge is still in there and back there. And this was all open field through here, and, you know, probably 20 years ago.
Really? So all this is just 20 some years. Actually, you know, I seem to recall that this has changed. We've been here 25, 26 years now.
Well, probably there was an airstrip cut, emergency airstrip was cut on this side. Right up here, ways up through towards the cemetery.
Yeah, this has changed.
Don't take long. They worry about the trees, cutting them all off. Leave them alone, they'll go back.
Leave them alone, right.
And on the left, going up across the flats before we get up the cemetery here, is Farrer and Brown, the Wayne Brown houses. And I think it's the Farrer house. You can still see signs of where it was. The Brown house up above.
Cemetery here.
Yeah, you may want to get up on the bank and take
get up
a picture.
On the bank.
And over in the back corner there, there's a river driver, a lone river driver buried in
Gary Hill.
Gary Hill is buried.
Yeah,
there.
Gary Hill is
over
there. I'm going to stop here and take a look. I remember Gary very well.
I thought you'd remember Gary.
Yeah, Gary. Years ago, and he loved this area. And so he wanted to be buried up here, along with, was it the river driver?
Yeah, the river driver that was drowned here in the river somewhere.
The river driver.
I don't remember whether he has a name or not. He's right back down the corner, just beyond Gary.
Yeah. Gary wrote a story about the river driver, I believe.
I think probably he did.
He's got a story of that somewhere. I'll have to look for that one. You guys remind me to look up the river driver story.
Across the road, down the hill and up. The cemetery was way over right at the top of the hill, until the cemetery. hotel was right in the hill.
Oh, wow. When were all these buildings?
River Drive was moved to that after the loan company bought this.
This road here goes off to another town called Andover, which is off east of us.
When we were at the house, it's about 8 miles up over the mountain down at Andover Village.
The village is 8 miles. Step-type falls off the East Bee Hill Road, I believe. Kind of pretty.
This building here used to be a store years ago. Like nothing, had two quite active stores way back when.
We're going to turn around up here. This is
this was the house that Jack Brooks' grandfather.
This is the little village of Upton. And
the schoolhouse and the church on the right.
Okay, you guys want to take pictures of these buildings? It's not Grafton, but you just want to pause here for a few minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. That was the old grain hall.
Okay. Give you an idea of what buildings look like in this area. Did some of the other ones that are down, did they have shingles?
Quite a few of them.
Quite a few of them did, shingled like that.
Of course, back in the when the heart of the city was all here, the Abbott House Hotel was right there. And Cedric Judkin's store was just beyond that big store.
Uh-huh.
And Cedric had a big barn. He always had a lot of cattle. And there was a big house between this one and that one that's up there that had a big barn. Hollis Abbott lived there. That barn, this one burnt in, I'm going to say 52 or 3, but I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I know I was in the old town of Machias. My wife's brother owned the Abbott House when it burnt. My mother and father and a brother and wife and two kids were living in it then.
That would be pretty close to where that one is now, then?
Well, that's where the store was.
That's the store.
Judkin's store.
Okay, we'll go up this little road here.
Judkin's son built a restaurant beside of it. They called it the Dump on the Hump.
Dump on the Hump.
And everybody kept telling him that the creosote was running out of the chimney. He was going to burn the place up, and he did.
And it did.
Down in February, one night when he was about 20 below zero on the wind blew.
Of
course, the closest fire department was Arrow, which is 10 or 12 miles.
Yeah.
And the time they got over here, the pump had all froze up, so they couldn't pump water with it. But the store sat right in there somewhere. Well, there was just the driveway between the store and the Abbott House Hotel.
Okay. Are you gonna stop here?
Yeah, Francis wants to.
Let's get a little picture here. Okay. We'll just pause a second or two.
And this Cedric Judkins built this up after the house burned and the store. And I'm not sure.
Okay. How many rooms did the Abbott House have?
The house had probably a dozen or so.
Dozen. Were they long time? Like people would stay whole summer?
This was a summer place.
Yeah.
In fact, there was the Abbott House here and Durkee's Lakeside House down below, down the hills, and over in New Hampshire a little ways there was another hotel. So this really was a big summer place.
That's a concept which we're not used to nowadays, the idea of coming in summer.
Come and stay in.
Come and stay for a whole summer in one place. Lost the row house up in Swan's Corner, and that burned down a couple years ago. And then, of course, the Poplar was another one.
Poplar Tavern,
Tavern. I was telling the boys about that on the way up.
Around
1900. It was quite a set of buildings that were.
This field here, that house way up in back, that was all cleared fields in back of that house, in fact.
Stan and see if they'll share some of his photos with us.
Mr. Davis. You remember he had left his diary in the courier? And I can now read. Spent quite a lot of time in draft on it. A lot of his writing had to do with things that he did in draft.
Yeah.
In fact, he owned the last house.
Yeah, just keep it like that, that's fine, so it's not shaking that. So.
Yeah, I guess it crosses the East Bee Hill Road somewhere.
Yeah, it crosses up higher than it used to. It used to go down Fry Brook, down by, called the Cataracts.
The Cataracts, that's right.
Down through there. Comes up this way and crosses further up above. Late 70s, probably, my cousin, half brother from Pennsylvania and his wife were up here. And Sylvia was up on Old Speck with them on Wednesday. And Friday, they wanted to move a saddleback. So they had a brother Owen bring us up and drop us off in the lodge at 8 o'clock. And they picked us up on the HP Hill Road at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Probably wouldn't make it.
That's quite a
hike. When the scenic byway was getting started, we were talking about trying to get a scenic place here.
Specs.
Oh. You have to go way, way back.
Somebody asked me the other day how Sunday River happened to be named Sunday River. I think I read somewhere that they discovered it on Sunday, so they called it Sunday River.
Might as well. Yeah.
That's good to guess, then.
Yeah. We have a little tiny cabin on Sunday River.
Your cabin
you know where that is.
Way upper end.
Yes.
You're in Riley, actually.
We're in Riley. Yeah. That's right. Our cabin got in the news because of the river study. Yeah, we see all that vegetation. Thank you.
You can take it off that SEPTA effect. Just press digital effects. It's a thing.
Proceed when clear.
Oh, what the trail?
Actually, no. Whoops, that's a picture. Here, shoot.
Press digital effects.
No, press picture effects, whatever.
How much time is left?
40, like 20 minutes on the. Yeah, 20 minutes both ways. Like 15 minutes on the tape and 20 minutes on the battery.
Battery? 20
on the battery.
Don't get anything done, stand there talking only.
We can stop the conference.
Hey, I guess I have a
conference.
Same power.
So?
Yeah, because the water.
Now, who's the narrator? Who's the? You got it running? All right.
Now you want to know who I am.
Okay.
I'm Bill White, and I was born right in his grandfather was born in this house in 1846. And I lived here when I was growing up, and then I went away for 2 years to work for the forestry for about 20 years, and moved back in 73 and retired back. I've been here since then. Just a casual note, I graduated from Gould Academy in case you've ever seen this.
Thank you.